An alternative method for fixing a faulty laptop charging port. Laptop charging ports fail frequently, especially with high usage, and this ASUS 53 series is no exception. Without owning a hot air solder station, you'll have a high probability of ripping some tracks on the main board when trying to release the original charging port with just a normal soldering iron. But here I'm using a bypass method, and you'll need to buy a DC chassis charging jack and its opposing plug. The ones shown here are 2.1 millimeters in diameter. Disconnect the electricity and cut off the original DC plug on the charging cable. Strip off the cable's outer sleeve to expose the positive and negative wires and solder them onto the new plug. For those of you that may not know, the inner wire is positive, as is the plug's central terminal. Screw on the plug's sleeve. I also wrapped some self-amalgamating insulation tape around the cable and the sleeve. Find a suitable spot for the new charging port on the side of your laptop. You want it to be as close as possible to the original charging port. The new wires will need a clear route avoiding any hot areas, and they must not cover any screw holes or obstruct the laptop's cover or keyboard. Now to drill out a hole for the new charging port. In this shot you can see the original bypass wires which I used for testing. Later on I changed them as they were far too thick. Glue the charging port in place. I would advise you to hold the new port in place initially with super glue and then use some two-part epoxy resin to hold it rock solid. I didn't have any epoxy resin to hand, and I just used some standard glue and then some hot glue on top of that. Here I am soldering on the newer positive and negative wires to the new charging port. Make sure that these wires are of the similar caliber to the original wires coming from the DC side of the transformer block. Now to guide those wires around the rear of the fan and then onto the original charging port. This charging port has four ground solder points on the main board and one positive pad at the rear of the middle. Check thoroughly which pins of the charging port are the positive and negative ones for your particular laptop. Solder in place the positive and negative cables. I put some hot glue here to stop the new wires from lifting from the base. Reassemble the laptop. Turn on the laptop, then plug in the power connector and see if the laptop's charging light turns on, which it does. I then turned off the laptop and blocked the original charging port with some hot glue. Later on I used a black permanent marker to colour the hot glue and the yellow glue around the new charging port. One final tip, make a short loop with the DC cable and hold it in place with the DC power plug with some zip ties. This will relieve any strain on the cable. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them below. If the video was useful, please consider leaving a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.